Well, we've got this unit, two units back here. Built these covers quite a few years ago. Back in 99, I put these in. And unit's not working. I just checked the time clock. I checked from 4 to N. That's the control circuit, and it's a solid. It's making contact. If it wasn't making contact, I would get a reading like this, 237 volts. But I'm making contact in here. It's not on the frost. A little bit of mud today. And this next thing I did was I went over to the fall in the quagmire back here. A lot of mud. Next thing I did was I checked to see if this was open. It's the pressure control, and it's not open. It's making contact. If it was open, it would mean it's low on gas or had a gas leak and it's all out. I came down to the contactor and I checked the coil in the back, the voltage, and I got 230 volts. So the contactor should be pulling in. And I checked the voltage coming to the contactor. And we've got voltage coming into the top of the contactor, but nothing coming out the bottom. And the coil is, it's hard to get at right now with one hand, but I had voltage on it. So I pulled the cover off, and this bar should push in, and it's not, it's fried in there. So I just have to change this contactor to get this running. Yeah, I put this in October of 99. Oh, that's the old contactor. Let's mount this one in place. Change it out wire. Easier to change it up here. This is 230 volts, this system. Instead of you only need a two-pole contactor, but I carry the three poles around because you never know when you need three phase. Have to figure out where they go. Just do one wire at a time, pretty much. It's just the easiest way to do it.
worked on that one, I'm going to work on this one. Happy about the warmer weather, but geez, got hit with some allergies pretty good today.
Coil now, it's what happened. It's a burnout. Coil fried in there.
that's the old one. She's cooked. Used to be able to change the coils on those old Honeywells. They're pretty expensive now. These things are pretty cheap.
Summertime, the pressure would build up more and the second fan would kick in. The fans are on these pressure buttons down here. I don't particularly like those, but apparently it works. It's been working since 99, so. Liquid refrigerant was sitting in the tank. Boiling off right now. Whenever I put a unit outside, I put it on cinder blocks. They've sunk in the ground a little bit. Not that much. I don't like to put the units right on the ground or on a pad even. I like to get it up even higher than that. They called me one year and there's a flood back here. And water is right up to the top of the cinder blocks. But, yeah, that's good.
Okay, guys. Later.